can see all that shit on my table. Damn it. Hi guys, welcome back. Today we are going to talk all about makeup brushes. We're at the table. That's how you know it's serious. Makeup brushes are confusing. There's too many. There's too many different kinds. What do they do? What's the difference? Duo, fiber, natural fiber, synthetic, sponges, this crazy thing. Do you even need this? So today we're gonna decode makeup brushes. What do they do? What are they for? What's the difference? Natural, synthetic? Hang out, we'll talk about it.
Goat, horse, squirrel, badger, sable, which also means horse. That means that these hairs came from animals. This happens to be badger, this happens to be goat. And the benefit of that is that because it's a real hair, it's got a cuticle, it has more grab to pick up the product. Because these are made from natural hairs, these are a lot of times more soft. The con to these is that because they're such good grabbers, they really hold on to that product and they can be harder to clean. And you have to take a little more care with them because it's natural hair, it can be a little more fragile than another fiber brush. These are examples of synthetic fibers. Synthetic typically means nylon or polyester. Sometimes they're dyed to look more like a natural fiber. The pro to these is that they're much easier to clean. They're a lot more robust. You can really kind of abuse them. And because these are not real hairs that don't have real cuticles, they don't soak up the product as much and they can withstand heavy use. These fibers perform very well with liquids and cream products. And also the benefit to these is that because these are not derived from animal hairs, they're animal friendly. So if that's important to you, synthetic fibers is the way to go. Everybody's very familiar with the Boss Beauty Blender and the little baby beauty blender. Don't pay attention to how dirty everybody is. Look elsewhere. Anyways, these beauty blenders are not dampened right now, so they're at their smaller size. They are designed to be used wet because when the water is soaked up in the sponge, it takes up more space than the product, so it will soak up less. This one's by Real Techniques. It's got this flat side here, so that's really good for baking or cutting a line. This is the Makeup Drop by Beautycon. So this is non-porous. It will not soak up your product at all. It will just simply wipe it around to where you want it to go. I will use this to apply moisturizers or face masks. That's really good for that, but I'm not a fan of this for makeup, but you know, you do you. This is the old powder puff. This one came out of a Laura Mercier translucent powder. So you dip it in the powder and then you pam, 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 beat your face. So first here we have flat brushes. These are best used with liquid products. This is for foundation. This is for concealer. You can see this is just a shrunken down version of this one. I don't particularly enjoy putting on my foundation with brushes like this. So I end up using these more for face masks or moisturizers or primers. But this one's really good for spot application. So it's going to apply product to a small, small area without disturbing the rest of it. Okay, here we have another variation of a foundation brush. This is a tiny shrunken down version of this brush. This one is really good because it's a densely packed brush. You see how dense that is? So the liquid or cream product is gonna have a harder time soaking in. It will, but it'll resist it a little bit better. And this is really good for blending and buffing in. And because you see this rounded edge shape, you're not gonna get a harsh line. So this is a shrunken down version of this one. I will use this one if I'm concentrating on a smaller problem area or I'm trying to blend out concealer. This one is very densely packed. This one is another kind of version, but it's a little fluffier. So if I'm really trying to blend an edge, this one's really good for that. Here's a couple more face brushes. So you see here that this is a very densely packed brush. This one is also very densely packed. It's the same idea. So you can blend a cream or a liquid product pretty easily with these brushes. And they're easy to clean because they're synthetic fibers. You can get a nice clean line with this because it's not a rounded edge. This one's a little bit more of a rounded edge, so you can really diffuse the line. The stippling brush. So mysterious. I don't like to use a stippling brush for foundation because I just don't. But I like to use it particularly for blush to make sure that I'm not going to get a crazy clown cheek. See how fluffy that is and wispy? It will help protect you from picking up too much product and it will help blend it softly. The stippling brush is your friend. So for regular powder, I like to use a fluffier, more tapered brush. So again, same principle, these nice rounded edges are gonna make sure that we've got a nice blend. Don't pay attention to how dirty these are. Here's another example of a fluffy synthetic brush. This one's very, very, very soft. and I like to use this one for bronzer to help save me from myself, because if you grab maybe a little too much, this will really help to make sure that you don't have a crazy harsh line anywhere. Now, if you want a crazy harsh line, this one is the one to use. So this angled shape here is gonna allow you the precision to lay this exactly where you want it to go. When you've got a brush that's this big and this fluffy, it's hard to control where this goes because it's just gonna wash it out, diffuse it out. This is gonna keep it where you put it. Speaking of soft wash and diffused colors, we got the fan brush. Do you really need a fan brush is the question. Yes. You do, especially if you are getting into the highlighter game. You need a fan brush for highlighter because otherwise you're gonna have stripes on your face. You do not want stripes on your face. With the fan brush, because it's so wispy, kind of like what I showed you with the stippling brush, it will grab all the product, but it will lightly feather it out, so you will not get stripes with this. You'll be able to lay down color nicely, but it won't be a stripe. I don't use a lot of natural fiber brushes on my eyes for no particular reason. This one has a more firm composition. This one is a little bit more fluffy. So for this one, I use to place color, and for this one, I use it to diffuse. So what's the difference between these two, right? The shape kind of appears to be the same. They're both really meant for blending in the crease of the eye. So what's the difference? Well, the difference is, you know, one is natural fiber, one is synthetic fiber. This one's a little more pointed, this one's a little more rounded. I like to blend with this one when I'm trying to wash the color out a little bit more because it will really grab that powder product. And with this one, if I'm just trying to soften a line but not necessarily wash it out, I like to use this one because it performs that task really well. Okay, so the point is that anything with a very particularly designed edge is designed for a very particular purpose. So if you are trying to place just a small amount of color in a very small area, this one is gonna perform really well for you. This is really good for under the eye and in the lash line. This is a dense smudger brush. This one's really good for smudging out liner in the lash line. This one is angled, so you're gonna get a little bit more precision than you will with this domed brush. Eyeliner brushes. Do you see these brushes with these crazy angles? Why is it angled? Well, it's angled so that you can have a little more control over the precision of the line when you're getting close to your eye. They come to a really sharp little point. Okay, angled brushes. So I like to use this one on my eyebrows for dip brow pomade. I find that for my eyebrows, I need to use a firmer brush in order to get the product to lay down the way that I like. If I'm applying powder to my brows, I like to use a softer brush. This one's really good for that. You can use these to apply winged eyeliner. Also, I like to really use this one to clean up whenever I have maybe a little bit of mascara that jumped onto my eyelid. This tends to be a very overlooked item in a lot of makeup bags. This is an eyelash separator. If you have trouble either getting the mascara to go all the way down to the root, or if you have trouble with clumpy lashes, this is your friend. Get one of these, man. This one is little, but sometimes you'll find it on one side of one side is a spoolie for your brows, and then the other side is for your lashes. Sometimes it'll be like a double-sided comb, where this is like nylon hairs, like a toothbrush kind of, and then this side is the little metal comb. Get one. It will change things for you, I promise. I have very likely not included every kind of brush that there is, so if you want to see or if you have more questions about different kinds of brushes that I might not have talked about, let me know in the comments. I need to clean these brushes. That is step two. So there's a lot of options, okay? There's about a million different kinds of brushes. There's a million different ways to use them. And it, you know what comes down to is you can use this brush and do your whole face. It would take forever, but you could do it. The point is that each brush does something different, and it's just gonna make your life that much easier to do it using the correct tool. It would be like if you wanted to dig a big hole, you don't wanna use a garden spade when you've got a big mamma jamma shovel, right? It's the same principle. So you just find the brushes that work best for the look that you're trying to achieve, for your skin type, for the makeup type that you're using, and practice. Figure it out. You'll find your favorite brushes. I have. You know, I started out with the little sponge tip applicator that comes in the eyeshadow. And you know, sometimes it's still the kind of the most effective option when you're putting on certain kinds of eyeshadow formulas. So you know how you figure out which brushes to use?
You try them. I prefer this to this, and I wouldn't have known that had I not tried either of them. All right, so tell me about your favorite makeup brushes and the ones that are not so much your favorites. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. You can follow me on Snapchat and Instagram, and you can subscribe. Is that the button? Is it on that side? I don't know. I'll see you in the next video. Bye. Okay. Whoa, what language was that? I don't know what to say about it. Jazz hands. Cats are going bonkers. Gizmo, son of the bitches. Aw, Tyler's on his way home. This is not going how I want it to go. It's so noisy down here. Okay, I think that's enough fucking torture. All of a sudden, they look orange. It was fucking fine a second ago.